today how to remove a locked up seatbelt on a 2015 VW Beetle and how to replace it with a new used one. First of all, you have to take all the clips and panels and whatnot off of it, and I've assembled all the tools I think I might need. So right here is what we're going to be looking at here. First of all, you have to remove this handle mechanism and then pry up on all this. So we'll be doing that and screw in a washer. That is removed. We will do a little prying. Seatbelt was locked up, didn't have a passenger in it when it went off, so we're gonna have to cut that off before we remove this because it's being held in. We'll do that in a second. But before we do that, we have to take the this panel back away from the car, and there is a clip here, a clip there. Yes, there's one little screw down here that has to be popped out. Thank you. discovered from doing the driver's side. All we have to do is pry this out just a little bit. We'll use a block of wood to hold it out so it clears everything that we have to get to. And I'll bring the camera over here and show you what we're talking about here. Here is the bolt for the seatbelt itself. There's a guide here, two screws that have to come loose, and then that comes loose. And these are the clips that were just popped out. There's two clips. There's one down here and one here that we should probably remove and put into the door panel when we do put the thing back together, because it'll be much better to have them there to replace the panel. There we go. So, and then we have to remove the plug, which is that. You pull that black locking tab out, squeeze, and pull. That unplugs it. And then to take the bolts out of the seat belt and the guide and whatnot. You have this is what you have, like a star head. And we'll take that off. This is the right size, right? This one. It's already in the wrench. There we go. This is what I'm gonna get. Yes. It's loose. Panel here. This guide here, I'm gonna take one screw out, loosen the other, and just slide the belt sideways off of from behind that. That way, you don't have to take the entire both screws out. One out. carpeting back and slide this off and put the slug new one on. So I think I may and you have this little job here. It has a little plastic cap on it. And it's just a slot, straight slot screw. So I'm using a small screwdriver. In there, which is this. And this plastic pulls away. And this is all connected. And it's just steel snaps. And you just pull that up and out. And then, oops. And then this is what I'm doing here. This is what I'm doing. You can see that. So, you have to pull the carpeting back. Other bolt that has to come out. This off of it and slide the new one on. And you should there's a little barcode insignia thing here that should be to this side so that when it's on the car you don't see it. That's the screw that comes out of that bracket that you can then slide. You slide this off of it. You gotta work it through there. Bit of a pain, you gotta work it through there past the carpet. Insulation carpet, pull that up and slide it off of the back of the and replace it with the new one. So I'll set the camera down. Sailor, so I couldn't tell you whether it was or not. So, okay, removed it. That's been loosened and removed. That's through the. It's already been unplugged. Slide it out. Set it off to the side. And so that we have the same sequence of routing the thing through all the little behind the silver. Last what I was telling you about, we'll snake it through all the openings sequentially so we don't miss anything. Make sure it's flush and running in the same line as the old one so that it retracts the same as the original. There. We'll be sliding out and loosen the other one. Find the same.